Listen up as Gerry Ryan, gazillionaire businessman, caravan manufacturer, Melbourne Cup winner, and Walking with Dinosaurs producer shares his secret sauce to success.
Welcome to the Small Business Big Marketing Show, where successful small business owners share their secrets to take your marketing to the next level. Now here's your host, Tim Reid.
G'day, motivated business owner. It is Timbo Reid here coming to you from Melbourne, Australia. Welcome back to another episode of the world's number one small business marketing show. And well done to you for finding it. A show laser focused on helping you grow a business you love through some very, very smart marketing. To that end, let's get stuck in to some marketing G-O-L-D.
Small Business Big Marketing with Tim Reid.
Big show today, team. I have got some very big guest announcements, some news about my pending 200th episode, and I have a fireside chat with gazillionaire businessman Gerry Ryan of Jayco Caravans about how to be a gazillionaire and what it takes. Very, very fascinating discussion. But first, a quick rant. Actually, it's more of a plea. Now, I say this with love, but can my local pizza shop please, please get a website? One page will be fine. Just whack a menu up. That way, when the Reid family can't decide what to order, we can at least pull up your menu and sort things out. Like, what is not having a website all about? I mean, seriously. I don't care if you are the most Luddite of pizza shop owners. You should have realised by now, it's 2014, that there's a whole lot of people doing stuff, buying stuff, finding stuff online. And by the way, listener, if you aren't a pizza shop owner, then don't think this rant doesn't apply to you. I see websites lacking content details often. Websites for service-based businesses without a single photo of their people. And websites bursting with testimonials, but very little benefit-driven content. We live in a world of what's in it for me, as you may well know. Now, I could keep going on, but I'll only get worked up, and that can only end in tears. Here's the thing. Your website is important. Right now, until something else shows up, it's the center of your digital universe around which all other activity, online and offline, revolves. So ask yourself this. What is the big question my prospects want answered? Then, is the answer front and center of my website? Two questions you got to answer. Now back to my pizza man. Firstly, get a website. Then, answer the big question. In his case, what's on the menu? By having one. This marketing stuff, it's not rocket science.
Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Now, are you keen to get your online marketing sorted like my pizza man needs to? One complaint I hear from small business owners a lot is that they can't get a break with their online marketing. They'll be having the worst experience with their website developer, their site will keep crashing, the design's nothing like they wanted, blah, blah, blah. I tell them they need to talk to Net Registry because they will get your online marketing sorted. You don't need to be a pro when it comes to the internet because they are, and they make it all simple and straightforward. How much do we love simple and straightforward? Getting you a domain name, your website hosted, whatever you need to market your business effectively online. And better yet, because Net Registry are proud sponsors of the show and want to see small business owners succeed, tell them Timbo sent you, and you can take advantage of some fantastic exclusive listener deals. Visit netregistry.com.au to master your online marketing today. Now, I don't normally share upcoming guests at the front of an episode. I often, more often than not, do it at the back end of an episode, and I'm not sure how many people hang on after the interview's finished. Don't have a way of tracking that. That would be interesting. I'd love to know whether you do or not. But what I thought I'd do is share who I've got coming up, because I've been working hard on getting some really, really interesting guests for your marketing pleasure. So here Here's who is coming up. I've got Karen Jacobson. Now, Karen is the voice of Siri and TomTom. And she's going to talk to us about personal branding, about breaking through fear, about recalculating your business direction. Really, really interesting interview. Already done that one. Got one coming up with TV personality David Rain. David used to be on Getaway. He used to be the host of the Today Show. He has made a massive career move into real estate, and I talked to him about that. I have got a fireside chat coming up with a brothel madam. Yep. Can't wait for the puns in that one. I also am doing a live Q&A session as part of a roadshow I'm doing for the Westpac Banking Corporation with Miss Chu, previous guest, and Brad Smith of BRAP, previous guest. And we're doing a live Q&A panel next week in Sydney for Westpac, and I am going to record that and turn that into an episode. I have also got Warwick Kappa. Yep, Kappa, coming on the show in a few weeks' time. Now, if you are an overseas listener, you're going to go, who's Warwick Kappa? I will put a link to a video that explains who Warwick Kappa is in the show notes for this episode 189 at smallbusinessbigmarketing.com. He's an old footballer from the 80s, and he's made a career out of being a bit of a duffer. And I actually think he's smarter than we give him credit for. You can reserve your judgment on that one. But looking forward to talking to Kappa. And I am chasing Jordan Belfort, the Wolf of Wall Street. Can't promise that one, but I am chasing him down. All the others are confirmed. So we have got some very, very exciting guests coming up. And if you know someone you think would be interesting to have a listen to, then feel free to introduce them to me. Looking for successful small business owners cranking out some great marketing of some sort. Just email me, tim@smallbusinessbigmarketing.com. Now, a few weeks ago on an episode of Funny Business with Griffo and I raised the idea of celebrating the 200th episode of this show. Wasn't sure whether I should or not. Griffo reckons I should. Spoken to a few other people. They said, yeah, make some hoo-ha. So I am looking into ways of doing that. And what I'm thinking of doing is a live show in Melbourne. Now, this is absolutely planning stages, team. So I can't give you a date or anything just yet. But I have planned the running sheet. I am working on finding a suitable venue, which will make or break the idea, because it really does need to be a suitable venue. Needs to, good acoustics, good place for you, you know, if you're going to come along, to be comfortable and be able to watch the show, blah, blah. But so looking at that, that will kind of make or break it. It will be mid-August 2014, and it will be a ticketed affair, and the tickets will be discounted for forum members as well. So don't know how much, not going to be a whole lot, but do want it to cover costs. So look out for that. If you want to be the first to know, and it's not going to be hundreds and hundreds of tickets available, it'll be a first-in, first-serve affair. Head over to smallbusinessbigmarketing.com and just get on my database by leaving me your first name and email address. I'll actually send you a little video I created called 10 Marketing Wake-Up Calls, but you will also go onto my email list and you're the first to know when I have some news. And in this case, news about a potentially live 200th episode. Righto, let's get stuck into today's guest. It is Gerry Ryan. I met Gerry at the Caravan and Camping Association's National Conference in Tasmania a few weeks ago, where we were both speaking. And Gerry spoke before me and shared his business journey in a very, very humble way. But boy, oh boy, has he got some achievements under his belt. He started Jayco Caravans in 1975 and built it to the biggest manufacturer of caravans in Australia and New Zealand. He's made a lot of dough. He's a gazillionaire. And he now spends a lot of time spending his money effectively elsewhere. He is the producer of Walking with Dinosaurs. He brought that to Australia, as well as War Horse. He owns a Melbourne Cup winning horse. He has a team in the Tour de France. and he is the president of Cycling Australia. He's got so many achievements under his belt, and he really basically came on and very kindly shared his secret sauce to success. So I started off by asking Gerry whether he still heads off on the odd caravanning adventure or whether we're more likely to see him around the pool at the Beverly Hills Hilton.
Every woman, every man, join the caravan of love.
No, in fact, I do get the Beverly Hills Hilton or resort in Tuscany, but no, we still get out. I enjoy driving the motorhome, and I have a park up at Ngambi, which I go and visit and stay in a cabin, so... Yes, it's a great lifestyle, and I still enjoy it.
What's the Gerry Ryan caravan look like, out of interest?
Well, what I do, I just take the odd one as a prototype to have a look. I think that's the best way to redesign your product or improve your product is use it.
Yeah, right.
I always say that, you know, I tell my engineers and designers, never fall in love with your product, because once you do... you don't see what the product is really about, and you've got to think like a customer, like a user, so that you can always look to try and improve the product.
That's interesting. I noticed, in fact, you just had a sip from your Ferrari mug. Do you think, so never fall in love with your product as the designer or engineer of that product. I'm guessing, like the boys in the Ferrari factory, would be passionately in love with their product. Would they not therefore look at it from a customer's point of view?
Yeah, there's two things. There's one, passion, and two, falling in love. You know, as you know, passion and love are the two different words.
Yes.
You know, you've got to be passionate. The secret to any success is passion.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, what happens sometimes, and I've seen people come along to me, Gerry, I've got this product, you know, it's the best in the world, you know, and it's going to have a long life. I say to them, don't fall in love with the product, because what you've got to do, you've got to keep looking for imperfections if you want to improve the product.
Yep. That passion thing, Gerry, we've had a discussion recently, and I have an online forum, and there's been a bit of discussion around this concept of passion. When you're passionate, I actually love the word passion. I think passion does lead to success, but passion can feel a little bit uncontrollable as well.
Yes, but end of the day, passion, interest, if you are interested in the product. People say to me, oh, Gerry, I'm going to go into business. I said, well, why do you want to go into business? To make money. Well, I said, well, that's the wrong reason. Mm. What you have got is your passion, or you've got an interest in developing a product or marketing a product, and along with that will come money. So, you know, passion, I use the word passion a lot. As I said, passion and in love are two different.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about that, because in 1975 you started Jayco Caravans. Was there a passion then? Why did you start Jayco?
Well, the reason why I started, I was working for a company that I had the opportunity to spend a few weeks in America looking at production techniques of how to build caravans, camper trailers. Came back all excited, passionate about making change, and I was working for a company that I was only 23 at the time, and had a lot of senior management that they were quite happy with how we were doing business in that time. They didn't want to change, probably because it was going to make extra work for them. But and that's how I ended up with Jayco. I became frustrated with the organisation, said, hey, let me start up on my own. So going back when I was... 24 at the time, mm-hmm. I set up Jayco.
And what level of success did you have in mind when you started? You just wanted to make caravans, or did you actually have the immediate idea of, you know, you wanted to build an empire?
No, I confess up today and say that I never realised back then that Jayco would be the size of company it is today, producing 10,000 units, mm-hmm. and having 45% of the market. I've got 80 competitors.
80?
and to do that. But back then, I had about, we started out building one a day. I built 600 the first year. And at that stage, I probably would have had about 2% of the market.
Mm-hmm. It sounds like, I've spoken to Brian Singer from Rip Curl a couple of years ago, and likewise, he had a little shop in Torquay. He had a World War II sewing machine, and he was just making these wetsuits for his mates so that they didn't get cold down at Bell's. Was that similar for you?
Very similar, and in fact, I know Brian, and he travels around. He's got a Jayco.
Has he?
And Greenie, they go around surfing, and we had a bit of success with a horse that won the Derby. Joe, back in about 2005. Good guy, and a great success story.
Great fellow, and he's a great success story. So really, like in 1975, you're away, you're making caravans, and you kind of, at what point then, was there a point where you go, hang on, this is getting serious, and it looks as though it could be something pretty special?
Well, back in those days, business was a little bit different. We drifted on. We didn't have the same disciplines we need to have today. It was probably, I diversified into property development. I saw people making money quicker in property. At the time, the caravan industry was on a downturn. I got serious back in 1991, after the recession. I had a holiday in America, saw the American economy was improving, came back and decided I've got to spend more money on engineering, improve the product, and more money on marketing, and more money on training. I can't grow personally, nor can the staff, unless we develop ourselves. And so training.
So that's quite a period of time, 75 through to, was it 91 when you kind of had that aha moment?
Yes. Yep.
Huh. All that, so that's 16, 17, oh, geez, my maths, hey? 16 years of just plodding along.
Oh, we weren't plodding along with business, but, it was a different environment. The caravan industry was a victim of themselves. They hadn't changed the product. The caravan parks hadn't updated. And it was really back in 91 that the whole industry, and I got the whole industry together with a couple others and formed a national body to grow the industry. We suffered from an image problem and an awareness of what our products did. So, and that all started in 91.
Well, then let's talk about that, because it fascinates me that as a bloke, I've never owned a caravan. I think I have a friend of a friend who owns a caravan. I know nothing about caravanning, but Jayco as a brand is quite strong in my mind. Why is that?
Well, early days, I always believed in PR. It was more credible advertising. We worked with journos, got familiarisation to us, let them take the product. So we tried to put the product out there, the brand. We did a lot of sponsorship early days, and built the brand up from the shorts of jockeys to cycling.
That's what it was. You used to be on jockeys' silks.
Silks.
Ah!
It's their backside, Jayco. So through sport, we've done it, and sponsoring a lot of local charities. We've had a cross section of promotion, but PR very strong. Today, social media, your website, tweets and all
tweets.
That.
Tweets. Go on, you're showing off now.
Yeah. So we believe in trying to get the maximum value out of marketing for our dollars. It's very expensive.
Did you always believe in marketing from the early days of Jayco?
I very much so.
Right.
My philosophy's always been, if we build the brand, if we build for traffic for our dealers, and we still do that, mm-hmm. we do joint advertising with our dealerships. We sit down, look at what they're doing to try and add into our campaigns. So our dollars go further.
Okay, so your Jayco is it 100% wholesaler? You have no retail outlets?
Retail whatsoever.
Okay, so you rely on the dealers. So that's an interesting... We used to do this at Flight Centre as well, although we did have retail outlets. But when I was marketing manager at Flight Centre, we'd look to our wholesalers and see what joint ventures and partnerships we could do to get that leverage. So how do you make your dealers' lives easier?
Well, what we do, we sit down and have a business plan. They do a business plan. Mm-hmm. We base our business plan off their business plan. We have a marketing plan and budget, mm-hmm. and try and work and try and be more effective with the advertising spend.
Okay, so really looking to see what they need and take the heat off them.
Twice a year, a national campaign, advertising either summer, almost summer sale, or a factory run out sale in January. So we combine our advertising dollars and get the maximum exposure.
Yeah, okay. What does Jayco mean, Gerry? I don't mean like literally what does the word mean. I know I'm assuming it's a made-up word, but like as a brand, what do you hope it stands for?
It stands for value for money and quality.
What about more at a kind of emotional...
Emotional freedom.
Freedom, yeah, right.
Sorry, freedom to go where you want, when you want.
Yeah, right. So like campaigns, I guess, like the Jeep campaign, and don't know whether you've seen the Corona beer campaign from Where You'd Rather Be, but like that idea of people wanting to escape the humdrum of everyday life?
Yeah, Jayco's freedom.
Yeah, right. Okay.
You can take Jayco anywhere at any time.
And does that, if I was to go out onto the factory floor, is there a kind of understanding of the brand? Because you've got a lot of staff now. Do you kind of convey that to people who come on board as well?
Yes, we do. In fact, what I try and encourage and preach is that we're not building caravans. We're building dreams. And in fact, we're looking to, when we do sell our dealers sell a product, get a photograph of that family, and when the unit's travelling down the production line, we've got the photo, so you can relate.
Oh, wow.
It's just not another number.
Yeah, yeah.
As I said, we're not building caravans, we're building dreams.
Yeah, great.
If you go into our engineer's office and they're working on a project, they'll have on the wall, if it's for a family of four, they'll have a photograph of a family of four or a tired couple sitting up there. So you picture what the customer you're developing the product for.
Oh, that's powerful stuff. Yeah, like having, I call them your best mates, but in your brand, like be clear on who you're creating something for. And I advise my listeners to even get it down to a person, like if there is a person, their best client, like picture their best client, who they're making the product or service for, and always have them front and center. Yeah, it's great because marketing for me is kind of, marketing is what you do when you can't go and see someone. So if the more personal you can be, the better. Clearly, those engineers, they've come a long way, Gerry. I mean, they're a very rational breed, those engineers. So having them do that emotional stuff would be unusual.
Well, it is. And the thing is that what we try and do here, we encourage our staff. In fact, out of 15 senior staff, that 8 of them own Jayco. So we encourage the management to get out and use the product. And, we're booking in again in August. We take 20 of them, key staff, away in the product. So we all drag away a Jayco, and some of the best ideas that come out of those trips.
Oh, that'd be fantastic. A convoy of Jaycos heading off on a planning weekend.
Yeah, no, it's a great weekend, for product, but also as a team-building exercise.
Fantastic.
To spend some time with the families.
Gerry, I want to go back to that success discussion, because what you have done, you've built Jayco, and then at some point, and you've already mentioned you expanded out into property development, but you've expanded out into a lot more than that. You you started a, I guess I'd call it a production company, and brought Walking with Dinosaurs and How to Tame Your Dragon to Australia. You're the part owner of a Melbourne Cup winner in American, and you're also a big supporter of various team sports, individual sporting people and associations. At what point did you decide to kind of spread your wings? Was it once you'd made enough dough to go and chase your passions?
No, it just people have come to me, or I've seen an idea, and one of the things that I've been very fortunate, I've got good people that allow me to do those other interests, from the creative global productions, which has done Walking with Dinosaurs, How to Train Your Dragon, Warhorse. We've got King Kong, and we just opened up Strictly Ballroom. But I've had the right people in the right place to do that.
Do you mean to free you up to then go and do those other things?
Yeah.
Right.
And you know, they share the same vision and same passion as what I do.
Mm-hmm. How do you do that? Because, I mean, there's a lot of people listening to this who are control freaks, and by nature, many small business owners are control freaks. They give birth to this business idea, and then the idea of then letting it go and handing it over to someone else, and I include myself here, it's a very hard thing to do. What advice do you give?
Well, you know, and I've struggled over the years too, that once you set your business plan, I have what I call the checks and balances, KPIs or whatever, you know, on a weekly basis. Monday's the most important day of the week. I go through with the managers. You know, I'm still involved at Jayco a couple of days a week, so I sit down on Monday, go through what the business plan is. In fact, then I contact the other eight companies I own, and we go through with their KPIs, what I call their Monday scoreboard. You know, if they're falling behind, what resources you need, or how we can get up to date. But and you've got to trust. But it's the 1%, you know, I have checks and balances, where to go and look, you know, what are the key drivers in the business, and you focus on those.
So you're saying there are things that you just go, little kind of, what are they called, telling points, where you go and see where they're at and they tell you whether you're on the right track or not?
Well, according to their business plan. So they have their weekly reports, as I call it, the Monday scoreboard. And I know someone said, well, you're doing well. I've been in caravans for 40 years. I should be getting it right after now. It should be easier to do. Business isn't complicated. I always say it's the people in it. So if you get the right people, it solves the problem.
I had a fellow on the show last week, Gerry. His name was Lee Store. He's 31 years old. He owns BioSolar up in Brisbane. Incredibly successful entrepreneur. It's his third multi-million-dollar business at the ripe old age of 31. He operates entirely from his gut, entirely intuition. You, on the other hand, you keep referring to the business plan. Everyone's got a business plan. Clearly, you're much more considered, much more planned, less gut instinct.
Oh, no, intuition, you know, in terms of, I always say that the key factors are, you know, is one, your passion, your love, you know, the product and what you're doing. Secondly, it's planning. You have to plan. You have to plan. But you need intuition to know what, if that product is the right product or it's the right time to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Intuition as you come along, and on a daily basis, you know, you get a feel for what's happening in an organisation or where you go to or where may be the weak points in the organisation.
Gerry, has there been an ugly side of success for you?
Ugly side, I wouldn't say ugly side, but the bigger you get, the more successful you get, there's more responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
I'm responsible at Jayco. There's 1,000 employees there. At a technology company, you know, there's a staff of 45. I'm responsible for them. The hospitality group, there's 280 people. I'm responsible. At the end of the day, the responsibility or the buck stops here. So, yes, and there's a responsibility to the community. But, you know, business can be fun. You've got to make sure you enjoy it.
Can be or should be?
Should be. Should be. Not always the case. And, you know, you've got to make some hard decisions. And, you know, sometimes that's not fun.
What's the hardest decision you've had to make?
The hardest decision I've ever had to make is back in the late 80s. It was the only time that I've had to terminate staff that it wasn't their fault. Why they'll lose me a job. So it was an economy at the time. And the only time, that was probably the hardest decision, because I was affecting their life, their families and their future.
Mm-hmm. That would be hard. What's next for you?
Next for me is some new product at Jayco, some new product which we're working on, some innovative product that we'll release in 2015 with a whole new marketing campaign.
What's the innovation? I'd love innovation. What can you do in a caravan that hasn't been done?
Oh, there's plenty of things to go yet. We're building what we call toy halls, motorhomes that you can put your motorbikes in the back. And in fact, we're looking to horse floats. If you have horses and accommodation, you know, that in the motorised. We're looking to do some small retro type caravan campers. It's our 40th year next year, so we're going to do a retro camper. So lots of things happening.
There's a lovely caravan I see every now and then in St Kilda, Melbourne suburb St Kilda, and it's big old silver one. It's sort of like something out of 1950s America.
Yeah, the Airstreams.
The Airstream, that's it?
Yeah, yeah.
Produced
today.
It still is produced today?
In America, yeah.
Goodness me. What's the craziest caravan you've ever seen?
Well, the craziest caravan I saw in America once, shape, skylights in the roof, mirrors on the bathroom, walls on the roof in the bedroom, you know, it's just in the decor, but I did never ever saw it at the next show. It disappeared.
I'd love to see that one. Have you ever seen, just to wrap up, have you ever seen the documentary The Winnebago Man?
Yeah.
One of the great documentaries. How funny is that?
Oh, yeah, it was. And, you know, it's a great story. And there's a lot of other caravanning stories. You know, you look at the Fockers, Meet the Fockers.
Oh, yes.
Boat home, so, yeah. No.
RV, Robin Williams in RV.
Yeah, RV, yeah, so it's a great lifestyle.
I reckon I can't help but think there is an Australian film that should be about caravanning. You know, we've had Kenny the Plumber. I think Australians' humour really would work well in a caravanning-based film. There you go. There's an idea for you.
It's a cartoon. I sit down with my young grandson and we watch koalas and their caravan. ABC it is. I forget what the show is.
Nah, much funny. I reckon the blokes that like Working Dog should do something. They've done the castle. They've done the dish.
Yeah, I know the boys there, so we should work on something.
Can you pitch that to them and I just want to walk on part, that's all.
Okay, done.
Good on you. Hey, Gerry Ryan of Jayco Caravans, thanks for sharing some of your tips and marketing gold on the show.
Perfect, Tim. All the best.
Good on you, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Every woman, every man, join the caravan of love.
Oh, I love that song, Caravan of Love by the House Martins, 1985. My kids do say that I spend too much time dwelling in the 80s, but what a wonderful decade. Hey, what a good fellow Gerry Ryan was. Before I share my top three learnings from that little fireside chat, let me share a pro tip from our friends at Swiftly. Now, as you know, Swiftly is all about doing small design jobs fast, like in less than an hour, for a massive $19. But Swiftly have just upped the ante. Now they're offering over 2,000 creative templates free for you. We're talking Facebook banners, Twitter backgrounds, business cards, letterheads, and plenty, plenty more. You can personalise them yourself or get Swiftly to do it for $19. Now that's got to be good for business. Check them out at swiftly.com. That's SWIFTLY. gazillionaire.com. Now, I hope you got a lot of pro tips from my chat with Gerry about what it takes to be successful. Three that are top of mind for me. Do something you're passionate about, but don't fall in love with it. That is an interesting concept. Many would feel as though they need to fall in love in order to be successful, fall in love with what they're doing in order to be successful. But love can blur the vision, can't it? So be passionate, but just don't fall in love with it. Number two, look for imperfections. Look for things that aren't being done as well as they could be and do them better. And number three, have a photo of your ideal client in front of you at all times. Fantastic idea. As I do this episode right now, I have a photo of Jamie Oliver. Now, he's not my ideal client, but he is the public figure that I base my small business, big marketing brand around. And I find that a really useful way of kind of channeling the vibe that I want to create for this show. So that's powerful stuff. As I say every now and then, it's a little bit woo-woo. And I know some of you are into woo-woo and others aren't. But, you know, if it works for you, do it. Hope you enjoyed that chat with Gerry Ryan. Righto, team, that is it for episode 189 of Australia's number one marketing show. If you want to keep the marketing discussion going, if you've got some marketing questions you want to bust through, join the Small Business Big Marketing Forum. Head over to smallbusinessbigmarketing.com, click on the forum button, and I will see you inside what I call the inner circle. A big thank you to Net Registry for getting your online marketing sorted and for supporting this show. And to Swiftly for those small design fixes done fast and those 2,000 free templates they kindly provide. Lots coming up, as I mentioned earlier. I'm Timbo Reid. You've been smart enough to tune in to the world's number one small business marketing show. May your marketing be the best marketing. Bye for now.
You've been listening to the Small Business Big Marketing Show with Tim Reid. Want more marketing goodness? Then visit smallbusinessbigmarketing.com.